Valijan. In today's session, we will learn about wave and propagation trailer. Order code is 10412. The apparatus required for experiments are:
first apparatus is goniometer base unit with the measuring unit. Another apparatus is, this is receiver arm with lag, and we have attached a stand on it, and it is connected to goniometer base unit. And this is transmitter arm, this is its lag, and we have attached a stand on it to fix transmitter antenna, and it is also connected to goniometer. There are different units which will be required in our experiments. So these all the objects will be placed on the goniometer between receiver and transmitter end, and objects are follows as: first is aluminium plate, then polarizing grill, then acrylic plate, aluminium plate big size, plate stand, aluminium plate small size, aluminium plate big, plate stand, and prism. This is microwave transmitter unit. This is basically gun diode microwave transmitter unit, which provides 15 milliwatt of coherent linear polarized microwave output at the wavelength of 2.85 centimeter. This unit consists of a gun diode in 10.5 to 5 gigahertz resonant cavity, and there is a microwave horn also. And this is microwave receiver unit with the horn antenna, and there is a digital display.
In first experiment, we will study about introduction of the system. In this experiment, we will basically study the microwave optics system.
First, we have to fix the transmitter unit to transmitter arm through this leg. So we have to insert this leg into a stand. And you can also tighten the transmitter unit through this screw. Similarly, we can see that we have fixed the receiver antenna to the stand.
So basically, this is our full setup with the transmitter side and the receiver side.
After that, we have to switch on the power supply on both the units. Now we have to move the receiver unit to 8 inches with the reference of goniometer. Similarly, we have placed the receiver unit up to 8 inches from the goniometer reference point. This setup is made so we can make the distance between transmitter and receiver unit about 16 inches. So at 16 inches on the receiver unit, we have to note the reading, which is about 2.4. After that, we have to keep the distance between transmitter and receiver unit about 20 inches. So the meter reads 1.3. Now we have kept the distance between transmitter and receiver unit is about 24 inches. And the meter reads 1.1. After that, we have to make the table in which R is the distance between transmitter and receiver, meter reading of receiver unit, M into R is the meter reading into distance, and M into R square. So first of all, R is equal to 40 centimeter, which is approx 16 inches. R is equal to 50 centimeter, which is around 20 inches. And R is equal to 60 centimeter, which is around 24 inches. And the reading corresponding to 40 centimeter is equal to 2.4, 50 centimeter is equal to 1.3, 60 centimeter is equal to 1.1. Similarly, we can take the more readings for 70, 80, 90 and 100 centimeters.
Now, for another observation, we have to rotate the receiver arm
at 0 degree.
As you can see, we have to move it to 0 degree. Like slowly you have to move it.
At 0 degree, the meter reads 0.1.
After that, we have to rotate the receiver arm to 10 degree and note the reading.
So, at 10 degree, the meter reads 0.3. After that, we have to make the table of angle of receiver and meter reading. So at 0 degree, we observe the reading 0.1, 10 degree 0.3, 20 degree we observe 0.4, 30 degree we observe 0.5. Similarly, we can take more readings up to 180 degree.
In experiment 2, we will study about reflection.
Rest of the apparatus are same as experiment 1. Only we have to use aluminium plate as a metal reflector and plate stands. First, we have to fix the plate stand on the goniometer, such as there is a hole. We have to insert it here. Then we have to fix this aluminium plate on the plate stand.
After that, we have to redefine the angle of incidence, the angle between the incident wave from the transmitter and we have considered a normal. As you can see, we have considered it from zero. So the angle between the transmitter to normal is called as angle of incidence. After that, we have to adjust the rotating component holder so that the angle of incidence is equal to 45 degree. And the angle of reflection is defined as the angle between the receiver horn arm and the line normal to the plane of reflector is called as angle of reflection. First, we have to set the receiver arm to 20 degree. As we have set the angle of incidence to 20 degree, now we have to move the receiver unit to get the maximum power on the receiver antenna. So at 50 degree, we get the maximum reading, which is about 2.2 or 2.3. Then we have to set the angle of incidence to 30 degree. At 30 degree, maximum power is 2.0 and the angle of reflection is 60. So we have to make the table of angle of incidence and angle of reflection. At 20 degree, we get the angle of reflection, which is about 50 degree. At 30 degree, we get the angle of reflection, which is about 60 degree. Similarly, we can note the different readings. In next experiment, we will study about reflection through prism.
This is prism stand and this is prism.
After that, we have to make the same arrangement as we have done in the experiment of reflection. In this, first we have to rotate the transmitter arm to some degree and then we rotate the receiver arm to some degree to get the maximum reading in the meter. After that, we have to set the transmitter arm to some angle. So the angle will be denoted as S1. So basically the angle S1 is the angle between the direction of propagation of incident wave from transmitter arm to the line of normal.
So S1 is equal to 20 degree. Then we have to move the receiver arm to get the maximum power in the display.
So at 100 degree, we get the reading, which is about 2.1.
So this is Snell's law of refraction. So N1 for air is equal to 1, S1 is equal to 20, S2 is equal to 100. After solving this, we get the value of N2, which is equal to 1.8.
In next experiment, we will study about polarization.
Rest of the apparatus are same as experiment we have done before. We have to only fix the plate stand and the polarizing grill on the goniometer.
In this experiment, we have made the arrangement as you can see. Now we have to adjust the receiver and note the angle of receiver, and at that point we have to note the reading in meter. Then we have to place the polarizing grill vertically.
As you can see it.
First, we have to reset the receiver angle to 0 degree.
At 0 degree, we get the reading, which is about 1.2. Then we have to rotate the receiver arm to 10 degree. At this point, we get the reading 1. After that, we have to repeat the whole procedure by placing the polarizing grill horizontally. After that, you have to make the table. Angle of polarizer for horizontal and vertical, and at that corresponding we have to note the meter reading. So at vertical position we have get at 0 degree we get the meter reading, which is about 1.5. at 10 degree we get, which is about 1 degree. Similarly, We note the reading when we place the polarizing grill horizontally at 0 degree at 10 degree. After that, we have to adjust the transmitter and receiver and for vertical polarization 0 degree to get the full scale reading on meter. And after that, we have to rotate the goniometer arm slowly about its axis and we have to observe the meter reading. So as we are rotating the goniometer axis, we can see the variation in our meter reading and we have to note these readings. So at this point we observe the maximum reading, which is about 1.4. After that we have to reset the goniometer arm so that receiver directly faces the transmitter end. After that we have to rotate the receiver arm. We have to rotate this receiver arm from 180 degree to 0 degree in clockwise and at different angle we have to note the reading in the receiver display. So as you can see, we have set it to 180 degree and we have to observe the reading. And the reading is 0.4. After that we set it to 170 and observe the reading, which is about 0.7. At 170 we observe the reading, which is about 0.8. We observe the maximum reading at 40 degree, which is about. After that we have to make the table, angle and the meter reading. Angle at 180 degree we observe the meter reading, which is about 0.4, 170 0.7, 160 0.8, and we get the maximum reading at 40 degree, which is about 2. In next experiment we will study about standing wave measuring wavelength. The apparatus required for the experiment are similar to experiment 1. First, we have to move the transmitter and receiver unit as close as possible. As you can see. And then slowly slide the receiver unit to get the maximum reading. And note the position also. So, the maximum reading is 2.4 at 8 inches. After that, we have to note the minima power by sliding the receiver unit. So the minimum reading is observed at 17 inches, which is about 0.2. So D2 is for minimum reading and D1 is for maximum reading observed on the receiver unit. So D2 is equal to 17, D1 is equal to 8, and the wavelength of microwave radiation is equal to lambda 2 D2 minus D1. So lambda is equal to 2 into 9, which is equal to 18.
Hence, that's all about wave and propagation trainer. Now, for further queries, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited, Jaipur, and you can also use this user manual which is provided. That's all about the experiment. Hope you like it. Thank you.